The MacBook Pro and 5K iMac have now been updated for 2019, and we've just finished testing them. So let's talk about what's changed since last year and compare performance to help you decide which Mac you should buy. Here are the specs for the models of each Mac we tested. Both pretty much spec'd out, except that we didn't pay the extra $200 for the better 8-core processor on the MacBook Pro, because you only get around 2% faster performance, which is not worth it at all. And for the iMac, we paid only $300 for 64GB of RAM by upgrading it ourselves instead of paying Apple $1,000 for that same upgrade, and it was incredibly easy and simple to do. You can check out a RAM upgrade tutorial video by clicking the card above, and we'll link the RAM in the video description below. We already expect the iMac to perform better than the MacBook Pro, but the point of this video is to see if the difference is small enough to make the portability of the MacBook more worth it compared to being tied down to a desktop Mac. For the 15-inch MacBook Pro, not much has changed except for the updated butterfly keyboard, which has new materials for the switches, which should hopefully fix the keyboard issues once and for all. Not only that, but we notice much better temps across the board and quieter fans compared to last year's i9 model, which suffered from a ton of thermal throttling. To learn more about it, watch our 2019 MacBook Pro review. For the 5K iMac, nothing at all has changed in the exterior, but on the inside, we get a new Vega 48 graphics option, which is much more powerful than the old Radeon Pro 580. Not only that, but the new 8-core performs extremely well and the fans are noticeably more quiet compared to the 2017 iMac, despite the old model having only 4 cores. Now let's jump into performance. Starting with Geekbench 4, we see around 10% faster multi-core speeds, which isn't much, but in the more realistic Cinebench R20 test, we got around 30% higher scores on the iMac, and that's because of the MacBook Pro's thermal limitations. So this shows a good representation of performance differences in processor-heavy tasks like photo editing, audio production, and programming. Now testing raw graphics performance in Geekbench 4, we're getting about 2 times more performance on the iMac, which will give you a good indication of performance differences in apps that use a lot of graphics, like video editing, 3D rendering, and animation. For gaming performance, we tested Unigine's Heaven benchmark, which gives a good idea of the differences you'll see while gaming, and the iMac got 80% more FPS thanks to that Vega 48 chip. And if you want to see it in action, click the card above for our 5K iMac gaming video. Now for photo editors, let's run some tests in the latest version of Lightroom. Importing 50 42 megapixel raw photos, they both only took around 5 seconds, so no difference there. Converting them to 1-to-1 smart previews, the iMac was a few seconds faster, but they're both so quick that it doesn't really make that big of a difference. Exporting them all to JPEG, the iMac was just a little bit faster than the MacBook Pro, despite the 30% faster processor performance in Cinebench R20 and the fact that it has 64GB of RAM compared to 32. So we're really impressed with the MacBook Pro's performance for photo editing. Now moving on to video editing and Final Cut Pro, the iMac is over twice as fast in the Bruce X benchmark because it pretty much just uses the graphics. Now stabilizing a 20-second 4K clip, we get around 40% faster performance with the iMac, but they're both so quick that you'll hardly notice the difference. Moving on to exporting a 4K H.264 video, which is very common for YouTubers, we actually don't get any real performance advantage at all because both machines are limited by the same Intel QuickSync exporting chip, so the extra performance of the iMac isn't really being used. Now here's a shocker, if we switch to 8-bit 4K H.265 or HEVC footage, the MacBook Pro is actually more than 2 times faster, and that's because it packs Apple's T2 chip, which features hardware HEVC encoding. The new 2019 iMac doesn't have this chip, so it takes much longer. And finally, for the more advanced video editors out there who edit raw video, the iMac starts to shine with about 2 times faster performance exporting a 4K 60 C200 raw clip, because there's no specific chip like QuickSync or the T2 chip that decodes it. It fully depends on both the graphics and processor performance for exporting, and that's why we see such a huge difference. Not only that, but timeline smoothness is doubled, with the iMac playing it back at the full 60 frames per second compared to 30 on the MacBook Pro. So let's answer the original question. Are you sacrificing a lot of performance by going with the portable MacBook Pro instead of the more powerful iMac? Well, for most people, no. Both of them are so powerful that the difference won't really matter that much unless you're someone who deals with raw footage or likes to play games on their Mac. For common video and photo editing, there's really no difference at all, and both displays are equally color accurate as well. Now a plus for the iMac is that you can go from 8GB to 64GB of RAM for just $300 by following our RAM upgrade guide, while it costs $400 just to go from 16GB to 32GB on the MacBook Pro. You can even get up to 128 gigs of RAM on the iMac for the same price that Apple charges for 64. And yes, it does support 128 gigs. So if you're doing virtualization or any task that eats up a ton of RAM, the iMac is the way to go. But for most people, we think the better choice is the MacBook Pro because we no longer have the serious thermal throttling issues from last year. And the portability outweighs any extra performance of the iMac in most cases. If this video helped you out, tap the like button, click the circle above to subscribe, and check out our iMac RAM upgrade guide right there, as well as our 2019 MacBook Pro review. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.